You. You are the master of your life, and no one ever should feel allowed to judge you. These were the words of wisdom that a very wise woman, my mother, always told me ever since I was born. She always told me that she was going to be the last person ever in the earth to judge me. However, ever since I found out about my bisexuality, my mind has been full of questions I still cannot give an answer to. Bisexuality is defined as potential romantic and sexual attraction for both males and females. For me, it kind of came out of the blue, meaning that I never really thought that I could be any different from what I thought I was, but especially from what I was supposed to be. Heterosexual. Straight. When I did something nice, generous, or kind, my relatives and my friends would just go like, "Oh my god, the woman who will find you will be a very lucky woman." But the truth is now that that person doesn't have to be a woman. It could be also a man. I mean, a very, very lucky man. And the idea of telling this out to my family, to my friends, this freaks me out as nothing else ever in my life. And my real question is, why? Well, coming out is a very strange concept itself. Coming out means that you are inside something else previously. Something like a box, for example. But I didn't choose to put myself inside a box, did I? I didn't choose to build walls and cages around me. I didn't choose to try to hide from everyone else who I really am. And the truth is that queer people now feel inside a box. I want to go through this issue within my personal situation. Why are people in a box? Well, when I left for Atlantic College, I had a very nice talk with my grandmother. A very nice, sweet, loving, caring, strongly Catholic and secretly right-wing woman. And her words of wisdom were these: "Remember, darling, that you can be whatever you want in your life, but just don't be communist and don't be gay, because that will kill me." Ha, good start. Or many of my relatives, who just told me that they were fine, completely fine with homosexuality and all that stuff, but I just really hoped that it was not to happen to me. Or in a friend context, back home, the word gay is used as an insult. I'll just use an example. If I was going out with my friends and I was wearing these trousers, they would just go like, "Oh my god, man, you are going gay." And really, I love wearing these trousers. They're so nice. But for the sake of not feeling ashamed, I just put them back into the box. Exactly as I decided to put my identity inside the box. Whereas it is true that I chose to hide myself, not to come out until not that long ago, it was not a choice to be what I am. It has never been a choice to be bisexual. It is just what I am. It is my identity. But anyway, let's go with another example. If I was hanging out with my male friends back home and I was to make a comment about a girl, a nice comment, something that doesn't involve for once the words boobs or ass, then they will say something along the lines of, "Oh my god, you're going gay," as they were saying, "You're getting malaria or something." You see, there is this inner homophobia, strongly rooted in the basis of our society, that forces us, queer people, into a box and makes us feel ashamed. And now the question is, why? Why are we this way? Why is this happening? I want to use another example for this, an example that I'm so sure can be related to so many other people in this room. When I was younger, from 6th to 8th grade, I used to be a very, very fat boy, committed to school only, with very short hair and very nerdy glasses. To be honest, I was always fresh bully material. And yes, I was mocked, teased and bullied for 3 years straight. At some point I was so ashamed that I didn't even want to go to school anymore, as ashamed as I was. I was forced into a box and I couldn't come out until I decided to lose weight. And certainly, it was good for me, but I didn't do it for myself, but for the sake of getting away from that self-imprisoning situation in which I put myself in. And I do not want this situation to happen again, not with this peculiarity of mine of which I refuse to be ashamed. The whole concept of putting into a box and therefore having the need to come out is so strongly related to the concepts of differencing, dividing, which actually can seem so silly to say, but it is actually a cause of major catastrophic events in the history of humanity. For example, slavery and segregation era in the United States of America. It was all bound to difference. People of color and white people. What did those poor people do wrong? Nothing. But they were black, they were different, and difference must be overpowered. Or during the colonial people in Rwanda, The Belgian colonizer just arrived and said, okay, now this land belongs to us. You are a Tutsi, you look more European, you look more like us, so you get the power. And then you are a Hutu, you look very different, you kind of look underdeveloped to us, so you will end up working as a slave for your Tutsi bosses. Forcing differences. In 1994, up to 1 million Tutsis were slaughtered in the most dreadful ways by the Hutus. And the opposite thing happened when the Tutsis gained power again. Because they were forced to be different, and difference must be destroyed. We have to say that we're living quite a paradox. We're here in United World College, this amazing international organization of boarding schools, where we predicate the values of equality within diversity, but here in Atlantic College, we're not allowed to hang on a rainbow flag in a communal area because it might be offending for someone. I am sorry, but for who and how? It is like, you know that we have this tradition to hang on the castle on the national festival of a country, the flag of that country. See, for example, let's say if I go on the Lebanese Independence Day, the flag is on the castle, and I go to any staff member and I say, look, the Lebanese flag just represents a group of people in this school to which I don't belong, and it really makes me uncomfortable, so please take it down. They will look at me as I was the craziest human being on this planet. This is the paradox. Are we here to change things, or at least try, or not? And again, out there, the heads of one of the most followed religions in the world, Christianity, as we speak, forgives by the eyes of God murderers, rapers, human rights violators, but still struggle so much to accept that people can be different in this way as well. Now, I'm not much of a religious person, but what I know is that in one of the commandments it said, love your neighbor as yourself, not love your neighbor as yourself if the neighbor is not gay. You see what I mean? This is the paradox. It's just so silly that we send shuttles all the way out in the space, out of the solar system to expand the boundaries of the known universe, but we're still incapable of destroying the small walls and chains within our small society. And now, queer people feel inside a box, which is a box of safety, it's true. But they're still, when they come out, they're discriminated against, they're mocked, they're hurt, and they are killed. And we know that because there are news on that every day. Now let's just flip the perspective for once. What if the people inside the box are not the queer people? Because there are people out there who think that we are in the box and therefore we need to come out. But the truth is, the people in the box is them. It is them who are blind. It is them who don't understand that this whole concept of hiding their true selves is just silly. It is just not possible to keep going like that. So now, queer people, though, even though it is true that it is those people out there who are blind, queer people fit inside a box, which is a box of safety, sure. And it is us, it is our close friends, the people we trust the most, and everyone else outside. It is nice, it is comfy, but it's just not fair. And even though there seems not to be hope, there is indeed. We're doing baby steps, and that's how we should keep going. We're here in United World College to predicate the values of equality within diversity, and then go out and spread them around the world. And even though it seems cliche, changes can be made, changes really can be made, but if we don't believe in them, well, no, nothing is ever gonna change. Not only queer people, but any discriminated group will keep living inside boxes, and the others will just poke their head under the ground and pretend that nothing is happening. Indifference is the most dreadful and most dangerous gun ever existed, and yet it's so easy to use. Let us not be indifferent. Let us not be passive. Don't be passive. Don't be passive because the same thing might happen to you one day, maybe in another situation. Because not everyone is nice and happy and kind out there. And out there, there are people who will try to find whatever is different in you to try to let you down. They will try to let you down because you're fat, they will try to let you down because your hair is short, for your skin color, for your cheap clothes, for your school scores, and so on. Now, let's face it, is it worth it to waste our time and our energy with people who we know will turn their back to us in the moment they will find out that, for example, we are homosexual? Is it worth it to waste our time with them? No, it's not. So take off those masks right now. Show the world who you are, because you are beautiful. And you are beautiful because you are unique. And you are unique because you are different from anyone else. Differences, peculiarities on a personal level in this case are what makes us all in this room and everyone around the world so beautiful. This is not just for LGBT people, really, but for anyone who feels alone and feels forced inside a box. Once my best friend told me, the right person is coming and is running as fast as possible. Let's just let this be a beacon of hope for everyone. And this means, again, don't waste your time putting on a mask with when you are with someone, because that just means that you are with the wrong people. People that maybe now you call friends, but at the end of the day are just a small bracket in your life. Because let's face it, it is impossible to keep a mask on forever. So, don't be indifferent. Be strong. Because if there is one thing, one true thing, is that the right friends, the people who are likely to stand by you forever, are those who despise the mask that you are wearing, are those who will try to take it off from you, and those who will just love endlessly what is hiding underneath that mask. And never, as now, I fully realize the meaning of the quote, those who mind don't matter, and those who matter don't mind. So, to conclude, there is just one thing, because there is no solution to this problem. And it is a problem. It is not a problem to be queer. It is a problem to be forced to hide from that. But if there is one thing, one true thing about this, is that we are not alone. Thank you very much.